is he. Greater is he that lives in you. Greater is he. Hallelujah. That is in you. That he that is in the world. And who is he? Who is he? He is the word. He is Jesus. He is the truth. He is the bread of life. He is the lily of the valley. He is the bright and morning star that dwells in you. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. Because he is. Hallelujah. He hath the name above all names. Hallelujah. I love Revelation chapter 1 verse 18 when it says, he, hallelujah, he is a person, Jesus Christ, hallelujah, have the keys of hell and death, hallelujah. He has the keys of hell and death, the keys and of hell and death, hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you turn to Luke 24, verse 1 through 12, talks about the women, hallelujah, that went looking for Jesus' body. Hallelujah. They were prepared, hallelujah, to rub his body down with spices. Hallelujah. In verse 20, in chapter 24, verse 1, it says, now unto the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto, hallelujah, the sepulchre. The sepulchre, which is the tomb, bringeth the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they found the stone rolled away. The stone rolled away from the tomb that the body of Jesus Christ was laying.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The stone was rolled away. Hallelujah. What are you saying? That the word cannot be held down. The word. In the beginning was the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God. If God is the word, what make us think that any man, our evil wickedness, our forces of darkness can hold the word down? The word must go forth. Hallelujah. Because the word brings life. The word brings healing. The word, hallelujah, will bring rise to dead. Hallelujah, Jesus. He spoke to Lazarus. And he said, Lazarus, rise up. Rise, Lazarus. The word spoke. The word spoke. Jesus is the word. Jesus is the word. He is the beginning. He is the end. He is the first. He is the great I am.
The word.
Hallelujah. If he could get up, surely you can bounce back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But there are three. You got to understand this in 1 John chapter 5, verse 7. For there are three that bear record in heaven. The Father, God the Father, the Word, which is the Son of God, the Word, Jesus, the Word, Jesus, the Word is dwelling inside of you and it cannot be held down. And the word was with God. And the word was God. Hallelujah. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And these are one. You have to remember who you are in Jesus. You have to remember, hallelujah, Jesus. And he is of life. He is of life. And in him was the life. John 1, 4, and 5. And the light was the light of men. Let me repeat it. And in him was life.
Yes.
Not death. All
right.
But life.
Yes.
There's life in the word.
Yes.
because he is a living God. And the living God living in you. How important are you in him? You are so important. And the only person that cannot stand you is the enemy, which is the father of lies, which is the devil, which is Lucifer. He come to steal and destroy. He come to steal, kill, and destroy. But you can come and have life and have it more abundantly. Thank you, Jesus. This word is so good. Hallelujah. And how can I bounce back? How can I bounce back? It seems like it's so difficult. Sometimes we question ourselves. How can we bounce back? I can't see no way out. Don't you be like that sometimes? I just can't see no way out. This been going on too long. Hallelujah. Seems like I can't get back on track. But Lord, I need you right now. Lord, I need your unchanging hands right now. Lord, you said that you will pour me out the miry clay. Hallelujah. Lord, I need you right now. I just got in some deep trouble. Sometimes we get in deep trouble. We want God to take us out and bring us out of it. Sometimes, hallelujah, Jesus, I just got into some deep trouble. How can I get out? How can I get out? I just was evicted from my house or my apartment, and I have kids that I need to take care of. Hallelujah, I need to feed them, but there's no food in my refrigerator. There's no food in my cabinet. But how can I get out of this situation? I need this man to take care of me, even though he's abusing me, even though he hitting on me, even though he talking bad and down on me, even though I don't have no clothes, I'm walking around with holy clothes. This man, hallelujah, I need this man to take care of me. Thank you, Holy Ghost. But God has a way. God has a way out. He is your everything. He is your everything. He is the lily of the valley. He will supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. He will take care of you. You don't have to stoop down for anyone, because God is the living God. He is our source. Hallelujah. He owns cattle on a thousand hills. He is everything that we need. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But we said ourselves, I'm tired of messing up with this man. Hallelujah. Every day, just for me to survive. This man ain't no good. I know he ain't no good. But how can I survive? I don't have a job. I don't have this. I don't have that. Hallelujah. But the thing that that's called is bondage.
Yes, that's right. Yes,
it is. Bondage. But God will help you to bounce back. The word of God will help you to bounce back. You don't want to be in a situation that you're in on tonight, but the word of God will help you to bounce back. Hallelujah, Jesus. God wants us to what? Hallelujah. There's three things that God, that we need to do. Three tools. It takes determination. It takes determination. Hallelujah. And maybe you may have to rededicate your life to the Lord. Lord, I have sinned. I don't even know how I got back to this situation, but I'm tired. I want it out. I don't want this anymore. I want to live for you, Lord. What must I do to become saved? Hallelujah, Jesus. It made me think about the officer, the jail keeper. He seen the gates swing wide open in the prison doors. He said, hallelujah, what must I do to become saved? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What must we do? What must we do to get back to that point that we used to be? What must we do? What can we do, Lord? Hallelujah. I need to know the tools. I need to know the steps. Now I know it takes determination. Hallelujah. I know I have to live for you, Lord. I know how to live a holy and righteous life, Lord. I know, Father God, And I come to you. I come to you with my whole heart. Hallelujah. I come to you, Lord, because I need you right now. I no longer want to be in this bondage. I no longer want to be in this struggle, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. And two, walk by faith. Walk by faith. God said, trust in him with all of your hearts and lean not to your own understanding. What is he saying? Trust in him. Wait on me. Trust in me. Trust in me. Don't look at what's going on around you. Hallelujah. Don't focus on what's going around you. If you only keep your mind stayed on me, he said, I will keep you in perfect peace. If you only keep your mind is what the devil's trying to take over. Your mind is what the devil's trying to get into. If you only keep your mind stayed on Jesus, and Jesus is the word, Jesus is the truth, Jesus is the life. Hallelujah, Jesus. No man can go to the Father but by him. Yes. Hallelujah. Walk by faith. Trust in the Lord with all of our heart and lean not to our own understanding, but in all of your ways, not some, not part time, but in all of your ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. He shall. You just gotta trust him, sister. You just gotta trust him, brother. He shall direct your path.
Yes, he will.
He shall. Direct. We got to remember that God is a faithful God. We got to remember that he's faithful to his word. We got to remember that he's faithful to his promises. He will. If God say he will direct your path. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father God. And be filled. Hallelujah. I love number three. There's something about number three. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will keep you, sister. The Holy Ghost will keep you, brother. You just got to be filled in the last evil days. You just have to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Yes. The Holy Ghost in order to be kept.
Yes. All right.
In order to be kept by him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And it talks about that in the book of Acts chapter, hallelujah, 4. Hallelujah, I'm sorry. Acts 1 and 4. Thank you, Jesus. Let's turn to Acts 1 and 4. And this is the good part. Thank you, Jesus. I'm sorry, 2 and 4. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. When this was noised abroad, the multitude came together. Can you imagine?
Yes.
That everyone's speaking in tongues. That everyone is speaking in the Holy Ghost. Can you imagine something is taking place in the midst?
Hallelujah.
In the midst, you yelling to God. In the midst, you allow God to just overtake you. In the midst of you speaking in tongues on one accord. God is able to shake that atmosphere. God is able to shake what's going on in your life. God is able to shake every chain, hallelujah, on that prison door that's taking place in your life. He is able. He is able. He is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you may ask or think. God is able, but you just have to trust in him. You just have to believe in him. He can do all things. If Jesus living in you, you can do all things who strengthens you. You can do all things who strengthens you. The word, why? Because the word of God dwells in you. Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Being filled with the Holy Ghost. Ananias and Saul, God sent Ananias on a mission. Hallelujah. Ananias, Paul was in sin.